detector.oem font was missing.
So there was no other way than trying to create detector.oem file myself. After the first reboot, it would still end up in an inaccessible boot device stop error. The line must be drawn somewhere.
And wow, did I give up too early? One of you asked if I tried the Unidata driver, and you were absolutely right, it ended up saving the day for getting Windows fundamentals for legacy PCs running on my Eagle Thin client. So I went back and retried the installation, this time using the Unidata driver. Sure enough, the behavior changed. I could see clearly copying files from the floppy disk during the graphical install. That was something I didn't notice during my earlier attempts with my own hacked up techsetup.oem file for the via drivers. Now I'm not ruling out the possibility that I messed something up with that file. But either way, the Unidata driver, with its broad controller support, was totally worth trying. And as you can see here, Windows FLP booted straight into the first boot agent and completed the install without a hitch. It even detected most of the onboard components, though audio didn't work out of the box. I also swapped the stock VGA driver for the S3 Unichrome one, just to tidy things up. Compared to the EPC, this machine was noticeably less responsive, no surprise really. The thin client only had 256 MB of RAM, while my EPC had been upgraded to full gig. So I popped in a 512 MB RAM module, which definitely helped. I also disabled the paging file to reduce wear on the compact flash drive. This box will mostly be used as a terminal client anyway, so going without swap shouldn't be an issue. Big thanks to the viewer who suggested the Unidata driver that wasn't even on my radar, and your comment really saved me here. You totally made my day and helped me wrap up this setup. I'm the Vintage Collector, and this was my short patch-up story from the trenches. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next Sunday.